Miss Ellie?
Yeah?
What are we getting up to today?
That's a really great question, Rosehip. Should we figure it out together?
Yeah.
So I think we should do something similar to what we did last week, where we looked for patterns in nature. What do you think about that?
Yeah, that sounds fun.
What patterns do you want to look for? Do you maybe see any right here that would be good hints for us?
Let me see.
What do you notice?
Well, I see, you know, lots of leaves.
Lots of leaves.
And on this branch, it looks like the leaves are kind of like directly across from each other.
Yeah. Rosehip,
like there.
Uh-huh.
And there.
Totally. Rosehip, that is such a good observation. And that's actually a really important thing to look at when you're trying to identify a plant. How are the leaves attached to the stem? Should that be our question today? How are the leaves attached to the stem?
Yeah!
Okay, hi Nuzzle.
Hi Nuzzle.
So let's take this plant for instance. You notice that the leaves are directly across from each other. That's called symmetrical attachment.
Symmetrical attachment.
Can we say it together?
Symmetrical attachment.
Now let's say it bit by bit. So we'll go symmetrical attachment.
Symmetrical attachment.
Good work. Hi, cool. Nuzzle. So this here is symmetrical attachment. I wonder what these other plants are. Let's look. What do you notice about this one?
I mean, to me, it looks the same.
Yeah, so this is also symmetrical attachment. Isn't that pretty cool? And
yeah.
You know what else is interesting, Rosehip?
Mm-hmm.
These leaves are shaped the same as well.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, so these are the types of observations that we can make when looking for one pattern. Sometimes we find others too.
Cool.
Should we go look for some more patterns?
Yeah.
Great, let's do it.
Okay. Miss Ellie, wait up.
Oh, Rosehip, I was just really excited about this tree right here.
What? What about it?
Look, I found a different pattern.
Oh, okay, cool.
Look at the leaves right here.
I was just getting to saying symmetrical.
Symmetrical. Yeah, one more time.
Symmetrical.
And now say it in a really high voice. Symmetrical.
Symmetrical.
Exactly. Different pattern. See how it goes one plant on one side, jumps down the stem, and then the other plant on the other side. Jumps down the stem, and then the other plant on the other side.
Oh, okay. I see, so they're not directly across from each other.
No, this is called asymmetrical.
Asymmetrical.
Asymmetrical. So you take the word symmetrical.
Symmetrical.
And you put an A on the front.
Asymmetrical.
Exactly. Good work. So here's an asymmetrical tree. How's it taste?
So yummy.
Good. But remember, next time we have to know what type of tree it is before we eat it, Rosehip.
Oh yeah. Sorry, Miss Ellie. You've told me that before.
That's okay. That's why we do this. Because when we know things like the leaf attachment pattern, like how many petals are on the flower, that helps us to identify the tree. And when we identify the tree, we can know what we can use it for.
Cool.
Yeah, great. So, curious kinders, it's your turn to do this now. Go for a walk around your neighborhood and try to find trees or plants, bushes, flowers that have different leaf attachment patterns. If you find any other than symmetrical or asymmetrical, be sure to tell me about it, okay?
Cool.
Rosehip, do you have anything else you want to add?
Oh, yeah.
Tell me.
Should they still take a picture of their favorite?
Oh, thank you so much, Rosehip. I would love that. Please take a picture of your favorite and send it to me. That would make me the happiest cat in the world.